I want to talk to you about quizzes. So Canvas has an old quizzing tool that you guys aren't going to use at all. You will see it. It lives in your navigation. It says quizzes. But we're going to eventually degrade this. We're replacing it with something we call Quizzes.Next. So don't worry about quizzes at all in your navigation. It's eventually going to disappear. For right now, it's still there, but you don't need to worry about it. All right, so I was starting to tell you about our new quizzing tool. We call it Quizzes.Next because it's supposed to be a next generation quizzing and testing engine. And it's in beta right now. And so those of you who have used anything that's in beta before, you know that it's currently being tested. It could be buggy. There are some things that don't work yet. There are some things that maybe they're working today and then they don't work well tomorrow. By the time you guys start using Canvas, though, with your students, it will definitely be out of beta and will be stable. But right now, as I'm showing it to you, it's currently in beta. And I couldn't even put this sample quiz or test in your course because right now, quizzes don't copy from course to course. If you export, it's just right now. It's just because it's in beta, okay? Trust me when I tell you that people would be leaving us in droves or like storming the main office if we didn't have a copy. So it's just right now that it isn't working. Used to work. For about 3 weeks it hasn't worked. So it's just a beta thing, all right? No one's going to freak out about that, though. We're all good with it. So what I'm going to do is show you what a quiz could look like from a student perspective. This is what it looks like. The icon for a quiz in Canvas is this rocket ship. This one has a time limit, so that will show for the students that it's 30 minutes. This quiz also does not allow students to backtrack. So it's going to be delivered to them one question at a time, and they can't go back. So once they answer a question, they can't go back. That's a setting that instructors will be able to pick. So we're going to go ahead and begin this assessment. My counterpart, whose name is also Aaron, built a really hard quiz for this example. There's a lot of math in it. I'm not a math person. I was an English teacher. So here's an example of a formula question. So 2.1 times 4. And I'm just going to guess. Okay. What is it?
4.
8.4. Okay. Thanks, guys. No, they didn't. They just watched me squirm. They loved it. All right. Notice that there's a timer that's running at the top. If students don't like that, if it freaks them out, they can hide it. They still have the time limit, but they just don't have to look at it. This is a drag and drop. This question's asking them to classify words into the correct category. So students will be able to do that in here. I'm not going to do it all, but I'll show you just examples of how that works. I'm going to click Next. You can obviously then put images into your quiz questions. There's also a lot of science in here. She was a math and science teacher. I don't know. I had a really hard time with this yesterday. No one helped me. Order of operations. And I was like, oh, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. But then I didn't know what to do with the brackets. So I learned that brackets go first. That's right, right?
Correct.
Yeah, okay. Okay. There's fill in the blank. There's also drop down, and you can have them both in one question. So roses are red and violets are blue. This is true, false. Best tool for establishing course flow is modules. Yep. This one, I got nothing. Where are the noble gases? Click your cursor somewhere in the noble gas region of the periodic table below. Anyone know?
Far right side.
So somewhere over here in the pink, I'm good? All right. So this is a hotspot question where the students then can just place their cursor in. So that'll read that. Matching, I'm just going to guess for all of these. So you can see what it looks like when we pick the wrong things. telling students up here how many questions they have to go.
22.
You're the best. This one I knew, right? I got that. All features that are available in your course navigation menu. All right, you guys got assignments and syllabus. Click next. And then this is the only question out of all of the ones I just showed you that the instructor would have to take action on. It's the essay question. So the rest of this is going to be auto-graded except for this.